beautiful Sunday morning. If you're here in this place and you're able to, the Lord has given you strength in your body, go ahead and stand up before him in this place and join us for worship and praise this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How many of you came excited and expecting for the Lord to do something mighty in this place? Hallelujah. I know that I did. So go ahead and lift up your hands in this place. Lord Heavenly Father, we give you thanks in advance for all the mighty works, all the signs, all the miracles, all the great outpourings that shall take place today, here this morning in Church Unlimited. God, we are open to receive whatever it is that you have set forth for us today. We're like a funnel receiving everything that you're pouring out into us. We're walking out of this place in the overflow, spilling over, getting all messy all over into the rest of areas of our life throughout the week. In Jesus' mighty name, we give you all the glory, all the praise. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Come on, give them praise in this place. Hallelujah. thank you for the fact that we don't have to strive, that it's easy, easy to receive the joy, easy to receive from you today. It's easy to receive our healing. It's easy to receive our miracle. There's no struggle in the spirit. We're not warring today, but we're stepping right in with a confidence, God, knowing that we're yours, that we have access to the throne room. Everything easy. There's no grinding. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Today to play church. We didn't come here to look you, hallelujah. Oh, but we came here to touch you. We reach out for the hem of his garment today.
Together today, I believe.
Come on, sing it. It doesn't matter what it is. Doesn't matter what the doctor's report is. I don't care if you think it's something big like cancer. It's nothing for the Lord. Oh, I don't care if it's hundreds of thousands of dollars a day. There's nothing too big for God. Oh, come on, let your faith arise in this place. I don't care if you're the only believer in your family and nobody else believes. There's nothing impossible for our God. Oh, come on, speak out with your own words. What are you believing Him for today? He's the God of the impossible. He's making it possible today. Hey, where there is no way, He makes a way. Where you see a brick wall, He sees a freeway that you can just go on and go. Hallelujah. Come on, we're gonna tell Him all together that we believe in Him. We believe in Him. Come on, we're gonna sing, we believe in you. We believe in you. You're the God of miracles. Hey. amazing, God.
There is
that our expectation shall not fall short. So we come today expecting big out of him, knowing that he shall not fail. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you. if you have to, shout if you have to, run if you have to, hallelujah.
Declare that name of Jesus. Amen. One, two, three. Jesus. Jesus. Thank you. So if there was even any little thing still lingering here, it's already over there on the freeway, man. Church Unlimited. Hallelujah. You made the best decision you could have made to be here this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Do we have any first-time guests today? Any first-time guests? Back there, welcome. Let's give them a hand. On behalf of our pastors, Pastor James and Pastor Cheryl, we want to say thank you for being here today. You honor us with your presence. If there's anything we can do to serve you, please let us know. If you haven't already, we do ask all of our first-time guests to fill out our connection card. We want to stay connected with you and also bless you. So if you didn't receive one, we will get one to you. So please let us know. Again, we want to stay connected. We want to bless you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. If you didn't get one, you can go ahead and pull your phones out and scan the QR code, and that'll go straight to your phone as well. So thank you. You guys can go ahead and greet one another before you're seated. Okay, we can go ahead and find our way back to our seats. Oh, praise God. Praise God for the increase, amen. Amen. right. So before we get into our tithes and offerings, just an announcement. So how many of you have been doing the 21 Days of Hope? Awesome, 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 awesome. Great job. So I encourage you to, we have, I think, like 6 more days, so to continue with that. If you haven't, it's not too late. There's still time to jump in and join in. And so I encourage everybody, if you're not doing it, to text that number, 760-450-9495. Text the word HOPE to that number, and then the instructions will be emailed to you. And so, again, we encourage everybody. We know we're going to see this place packed out on Easter Sunday. Amen. Hallelujah. And you can be a part of that. So we need all hands on deck. We need everybody on board. I know in the next few days we're going to have some, activities or actions where we can text our families, friends, coworkers, neighbors. And I think one of the days it's simple. It's like text three people that you know and invite them to church. And can you imagine if every person in this place texted three people and they all came? And just it's going to be rewarding to you as well, knowing that you took part in all that. You took part in the growth of this place. And so again, I encourage everybody to still continue with the 21 days. And actually right now, if we can go ahead and pull out our phones. I know a lot of you, including the youth. Even the kids, I know there's kids that have phones too, so well, ask your parents first if you can text. But so I encourage you to pull out your phones right now. We're gonna give you some time to do that, and either jump on Facebook or Instagram. So on Facebook, you can search up Church Unlimited, and then it'll be our logo on the profile picture. Or on Instagram, it's _Church_Unlimited_. So we ask that everybody go to the Easter announcement. We did this on Wednesday, so if you weren't here Wednesday, you have the opportunity to take part in it now. And if you were here Wednesday, then you can take part in it again. Amen. So go ahead and look for the announcement. It starts with Easter Family Fun. And we ask that you tag 5 friends in the comments. That's it. I know some of you have hundreds and thousands of friends, so just 5. Just pick 5. Tag them, and that'll help us get the word out. So I'll give you just a few more seconds to do that. And then also share it. Again, just simple. We see people sharing stuff daily, so let's share some positivity. We know they're going to be blessed if they come here. Amen. So we encourage you to please share that either on Instagram, Facebook, or both. Probably one of the only times that we'll encourage you to pull out your phone and and do so and go on your social media. Don't be rebellious. And even with the flyering, I don't know the exact days and times, but get with Brother Nick and he'll let you know. But I encourage everybody to take part in that. I was just thinking, like, can you imagine that one flyer that you give out to that person that, encourages them to come here, and then they get saved and then their entire family gets saved? How rewarding is that going to be? So I encourage you all to go out flyering as well. Again, if you have questions about the days and times for that, see Brother Nick. So we're going to go ahead and move on to the tithes and offerings. Amen. Get excited to be blessed. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. So I want to read out of the book of John, John chapter 6, starting in verse 5. So it says, Jesus soon saw a huge crowd of people coming to look for him. Turning to Philip, he asked, "Where can we buy bread to feed all these people?" He was testing Philip, for he already knew what he was going to do. Philip replied, "Even if we worked for months, we wouldn't have enough money to feed them." Then Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, spoke up. "There's a young boy here with 5 barley loaves and 2 fish, but what good is that with this huge crowd?" "Tell everyone to sit down," Jesus said. So they all sat down on the grassy slopes. The men alone numbered about 5,000. So that was just the men, including their wives and children. So it says the men alone numbered about 5,000. It was a group of 5,000 people. They had 5 loaves and 2 fish. Seems impossible, right? But we know that with God, all things are possible. Amen. So it says, then Jesus took the loaves, gave thanks to God, and distributed them to the people. Afterward, he did the same with the fish, and they all ate as much as they wanted. After everyone was full, Jesus told his disciples, "Now gather the leftovers so that nothing is wasted." So they picked up the pieces and filled 12 baskets with scraps left by the people who had eaten from the 5 barley loaves. And then I want to go ahead and also read out of Matthew. So that's not, he did it with the 5,000. And then here again, it says, Matthew chapter 15, it says, "Then Jesus called his disciples and told them, 'I feel sorry for these people. They have been here with me for 3 days and they have nothing left to eat. I don't want to send them away hungry or they will faint along the way.' The disciples replied, 'Where would we get enough food here in the wilderness for such a huge crowd?'" The unbelief. Jesus asked, "How much bread do you have?" They replied, 7 loaves and a few small fish." So again, a group of about 4,000, they have 7 loaves and a few small fish. So Jesus told all the people to sit down on the ground. Then he took the 7 loaves and the fish, thanked God for them, and broke them into pieces. He gave them to the disciples, who distributed the food to the crowd. They all ate as much as they wanted. Afterward, the disciples picked up 7 large baskets of leftover food. Thank you, Jesus. So with that, like, in especially these last few days, like, God's been pressing on me, maintaining a grateful heart, amen, just maintaining that attitude of gratefulness and thanksgiving unto the Lord. There's power in that. It's something so, I mean, I don't want to say simple, but it's just, you know, just be grateful for everything. Amen. Just maintain that heart, that spirit, that attitude of just thanksgiving. And miracles happen in the midst of that. Amen. And we believe in our miracle working God. So I encourage you all, even when it comes to our giving, you know, don't look at it in a way where it's like, oh, I don't have enough. Like we just read, you know, Jesus, a miracle took place when he gave it to God. He gave thanks to the Lord, and then God did the rest. He made the miracle. Amen. So even in your thanksgiving, as we give willingly, as we give cheerfully, as we give with thanksgiving, amen, not grudgingly, the Lord is going to not only multiply your seed, but miracles are going to take place. Amen. The unimaginable, whatever seems impossible with God is possible. Amen. So I encourage you all to just give with that grateful heart. And then I was thinking, like, what, you know, the ultimate demonstration, expression of love that God did unto us, he gave his best, he gave his one and only son. Like, can you imagine giving Lily for the sins of everybody? Like, like, he loved us that much. She's clapping. He loved us that much that he gave his one and only son so that we may live and have abundant life. Amen. So us, in the same way, you know, we have to demonstrate our love to him. How much do we love him? Amen. And you're not giving to the church. You're not giving to the pastors, although we love them. We love to bless them. You're giving unto the Lord. Amen. So I want to ask the ushers to go ahead and hand out the offering envelopes. Sorry, I did that already. We have many different ways to give. If you are giving through that envelope, we do ask that you complete it fully with your name and all the information on there. We please ask that you fill that out completely. If you want to give through Cash App, it's $ the U Indio. If you want to give through Zelle, churchunlimited.indio2@gmail.com. You can give through the Church Center app, or you can text any dollar amount to the number 84321. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So, everybody ready to give? We're going to go ahead and pray and a blessing over our offerings. Amen. So cute. Father, I thank you, Lord. We come before you with grateful hearts, Lord. Grateful, Lord, for the privilege, Lord, the honor that it is to give back to you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that we can believe you at your word. We thank you, Lord, that as we give unto you, Lord, you're a God of increase. You're a God of multiplication, Lord. So I thank you that as we give to you, Lord, you shall multiply this seed, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for the abundance of blessing, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for the miracles that are going to come out of this seed, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for prosperity, Lord, upon the lives of every person in this place, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for houses, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for land, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for properties, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for supernatural debt cancellation, Lord. I thank you, Lord, that abundance is our portion. Blessing is our portion. Prosperity is our portion. Thank you, Lord, that it is your will, Lord, that we prosper, Lord, and be blessed. So, Father, I thank you, Lord, for all that shall come, Lord, all that shall take place, Lord, as we give unto you, Lord, cheerfully, Lord, with thankful hearts, with grateful hearts, Lord. And we are careful, we are sure to give you and you alone all the glory, Lord, all the honor and all the praise for it, Lord. We thank you for it in advance, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Hallelujah. So we'll pay attention to the announcements, and then we can stand for the man of God. Amen.
Just a reminder, our Christian Foundations classes begin at 8 a.m. every Sunday for the month of March in Lifetree. If you haven't already registered, we encourage you to do so online at churchunlimited.tv, in our events page, or at the bookstore. We cannot wait to see you there.
Just a reminder. Hey everyone, Church Unlimited is hosting a day full of family fun. Join us on Easter, Sunday, March 31st at 10 a.m. Bring the whole family to enjoy mega giveaways of TVs, bikes, and cash gift cards, free Easter egg hunt, free family photos, face paintings, kids' Easter play, free food and drinks. This event is 100% free and open to the public. It will first take place at Church Unlimited, 10 a.m. Then immediately after service, we will all meet at the La Quinta Park. It won't be a picnic style, so we ask that you bring your own chairs or blankets to feel the most comfortable. You can RSVP online, in our upcoming events page, our website, or at the bookstore. If this is your first time attending Church Unlimited, we encourage you to RSVP at churchunlimited.tv.
God is not looking for a church that is wanting to play church. He is looking for a people that believe him at his word, that know who they are, and stand on the name that they have been given, and walk in the authority that he has called us to live in, that we will not be stopped. No devil in hell can stop this church. Let hell be notified today. The church is standing up, and the church is moving forward. Believing God for 300 people that are going to be attending our Sunday morning services regularly in the name of Jesus Christ. And then after that, we'll start going to the thousands, and then we're taking over this valley in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. I'm going to ask you to continue standing if you're able to. I'm going to ask you to continue standing. We're going to open in prayer, and then I'll share with you what's on my heart. Pastor Cheryl is coming home tonight. Hallelujah. Praise God. I've lost a lot of weight since she's been gone. Praise the Lord. Food's just not the same. Praise God. But she'll be flying in tonight at 8 into Palm Springs, and then so I'm going to quickly, I'll probably be there at like right after church. Waiting for her to come home, but she's had a great time. She sends you her love. She actually got invited to lunch with Pastor Adonica. Pastor Rodney actually gave her a tour of his office. I said, "Hey, wait a minute." I said, "I've never got a tour of Pastor Rodney's office. What's going on?" So she was telling me everything. So I told her, "Calm down and relax till I get back there." Praise the Lord. But God is a good God. Praise the Lord. If you're wondering what this thing is, I actually got to turn it on, but it's a microphone that helps with when we're doing videos for shorts and different things like that. I put it down here because last time I had it up here and it was too loud, and I put it down here, so I already said a prayer that you don't hear my stomach growl. Praise God. And this button right here is already under a lot of stress anyway, so I praise the Lord. Praise God. So, all right, it's not that funny. You guys laughed a little too hard. Praise the Lord. The Lord is good. Yeah. Hallelujah. And his mercy endures forever and ever. I want you to say this with me. Man, I'm thankful for the presence of God that is already, hallelujah, that is already in this place. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I want you to say this with me. Say, God is going to do something good for me today. Hallelujah. I'm going to ask you to lift your hands towards heaven. Come on, lift those palms up on Palm Sunday. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you that you're good. We thank you that your word never fails. God, we thank you, Lord, that you drew everybody here today, that nobody's here by accident, and you have a right now word for every person that is in this place. No, none of us are going to leave this place the same in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for your word goes forth mightily and prevails. And we thank you ahead of time for all that you have done, are doing, and are going to do in this place. Thank you for touching every heart in life. In the name of Jesus, we give you praise. And God's people said, amen. And give Jesus another hand clap of praise, and you can be comfortably seated. Hallelujah. This morning, you know, we've been over the last, you know, since the beginning of the year, the Lord has placed upon my heart a just believing God for 300, hallelujah, regularly attending, not just anybody, because we can fill, it's not hard to fill a church. You know, it's not hard to fill a church, but we don't want just 300 anybody. We want 300 on fire, Holy Ghost filled, amen, fire baptized. And if you're not, you will be. Praise God. So we're not, amen. So we're believing. There's a story in the book of Abraham, in the book of Genesis concerning Abraham, where the Bible literally says that Abraham raised up 318 soldiers that he trained in the house. And that's what we're praying that God is doing in this place. Amen. And if you were here this morning, Brother Victor did another phenomenal job. Amen, on teaching and on the word of God, and that was at 8 o'clock, and some people thought, you know, you got here early. Well, there were people here a lot earlier than you, and it's funny because a lot of services, I was counting the hours that we, you know, some people, if it gets longer than an hour, they start getting nervous, and there's, you know, but in our church, amen, the reason why we put a starting time and not an ending time is because we're not done until the Holy Spirit is done. Amen. And I'm not going to put a time until the Holy Ghost, you have until this time in order to touch people. As long as there's people being touched, we're here. Can you say amen? I would hate to be the person that was the 121st person on the day of Pentecost. Because Jesus told everybody, wait in Jerusalem until you were endued with power from on high, and then you will be my witnesses. And the Bible said everyone, all the 120 were filled. I would not want to be the 121st person that said, you know what, 10 days, it's long enough, you know, I got to get my camel's oil changed or whatever the excuse was. But can you imagine, or you know, just in that fact, how many people were there and couldn't wait? The Bible says, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. Amen. If you came in here and you're a little tired, maybe it's because you needed to wait a little bit longer in the presence of the Lord. In His presence is fullness of, and at His right hand there are pleasures forevermore. Wherever Jesus shows up, it's always a triumphal entry. And that's what we're celebrating. You know, I wasn't going to start here, but put Psalm, did I say it already? Put, you know, this question right here, we get asked a lot. For people that come to our church for the first time, they look around at what's all this shouting about. Well, if you don't know, by the time we get done today, you're going to know. Hallelujah. His name is Jesus. Hallelujah. And we're not ashamed, hallelujah, of the gospel of Jesus Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation for everyone that believes. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen. So God is going to touch you today. Amen. Everybody that comes expecting, the Bible says your expectation shall not be cut off. Amen. God is going to touch you. You're going to receive exactly what you need. And God doesn't always do, He doesn't just do what you need. You heard Sister Kendra talk about the God of more than enough. Because anytime God shows up, there's always excess. God is a God of excess. That's why I don't understand people that think, God, just do enough. God, if you'll just do. God is not a God of just do. He is a God of more than enough. He's exceedingly and abundantly above all that you can ask or think. That's how God is going to move on your behalf today. I'm glad God didn't stop with the last one, because, you know, when something is really good, you want to eat it later on too. Some places I've gone to eat before and they ask me, do you want a caja? Do you want a box? Do you want a caja to bring food with you? And if the food's not that good, Sister Sam, I'll say no thank you. But if the food is really good, hey, hallelujah, even though I'm full, I want to take that food because I want to eat that again later. And I guarantee you today, the word that God has for you, not only is it going to, the Bible said, oh, taste and see that the Lord your God is a good God. Hallelujah, I'm guaranteeing you today. The Bible said, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Get ready, God has an overflow. Blessing net fish, hallelujah. Net breaking blessing for everybody that is in this place today. Every time Jesus gets involved, there's excess. Pastor Cheryl and I went to this church, and God bless everybody. God bless every church. But you know, it's funny, when our church shows up places, people that call themselves Pentecostals get him, you know? Our kids showed up to church camp, and they're preaching a message about getting the fire, and our kids brought the fire. Hallelujah. The Bible said the fire on the altar must never go out. We show up to services, and they're having, you know, Lord, send the fire, comrade. Brother, we have the fire. Fire, 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 fire. Fuego. Fuego de Dios. Brother, you don't have to get, you can live like this every day of your life. I don't just live like this on Sunday. We're on fire Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Sunday's just a gathering of celebration for everything that God has already done. We don't have to come in and someone hit a D3 on the organ for us to start knowing when to shout. Brother, we come in with thanksgiving. Hallelujah. We enter His courts with praise. We will say, this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice, for He has made me glad. The Bible doesn't say He has made me sad. It says He has made me glad. Hallelujah. The Bible said in His presence is fullness of joy. Amen. Where the presence and the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. Happy are the people whose God is the Lord. You may say, you know, like I always say, like Paul, you know, like Paul said, I pray in the Spirit more than you all. I say I probably cry more than you all. Because when the presence of the Lord hits me, it doesn't mean I'm sad. These tears are tears of joy. Because what happens is when divinity hits this flesh, when the power of God hits this flesh, you don't know how you're going to react. Some people will look at him, and I'm going to talk a little bit about this today, because we're talking about the triumphal entry and about how people surrounded him and said, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hallelujah. The Bible said they begin to worship him. People that are religious look at you, look at the worshiper and judge you. But brother, people that know Jesus is present, hallelujah, begin to shout, Hosanna in the highest. Everywhere Jesus is, and every time Jesus gets brought into a situation, it is a triumphal entry. And what happened is when you know, all of hell shook when we all yelled, when we all shouted Jesus. The Bible said, shouting unto God with a voice of triumph. For the Lord has, listen, you're not trying to get the victory. It says, for the Lord has already given you the victory. Brother, we're not shouting on credit. We're not shouting on layaway. We're shouting knowing that this over 2,000 years ago, Jesus has already secured the victory. And he deserves all the praise and all the glory and all the honor. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So if you could put Psalm 127 in verse 1. And I just want to make this point today because, you know, again, this is the scripture, and then Matthew 16, 18, which I'm going to talk about. You guys, in the middle, like I told you before, when I was working a secular job, before the Lord told me to walk away from all of it, and if you do it safe, don't do it. You walk away to do what God has called you to do. When I was in that place, I was never ashamed. When it was time for lunch, if I ever had time, I would sit there and I would open my Bible during that lunchtime. And when it came time to bless my food or pray or thank God, just like you heard he did, man, you can't run out of food if you thank God for food. The Bible says Jesus fills all things everywhere with himself. He doesn't like void. He doesn't like emptiness. Amen. You came in here empty. You're about to be leaving overflow. The first miracle Jesus ever did was fill 6 water pots. Jesus likes to party. Can you say amen? And it wasn't old wines and old wineskins. Brother, it was new wine. Hallelujah. And that's why we celebrate the way that we do. The Bible said on the book of Acts. Look, guys, we are not just Pentecostal in denomination. We are Pentecostal Book of Acts Church. We believe the Word of God from Genesis to Revelation. If the Bible says it, brother, we demonstrate it. These signs shall follow them that. How many believers do we have in this place? The Word shall be confirmed with signs following. So get ready. Hallelujah. Woo, thank you, Lord Jesus. The Bible said that, you know, it's funny because everybody that was in that room, people that see services like, you know, religious people get nervous in atmospheres like this. They're really going to feel out of place in heaven. Because heaven is not a quiet place. You know what the Bible, one of the reasons people say, why are you, what's all the shouting about? One of the reasons why all the shouting is, and I don't want to get ahead of myself, but the Bible says when one person gives their life to Jesus, then all of heaven begins to throw a party. Brother, there is shouting going in when one person gives their life to Jesus. Some people, you know, everything must be done in decency and in order, not the order of a graveyard. The most orderly place in the world is a graveyard, and nobody's alive there. Hallelujah. But there's living stones that are in this place right now. Hallelujah. Red of men. And God doesn't like, there's no, man, I'm going to tell you right now. God, where Jesus is a lit church. Where Jesus is a living church. That's why I love that scripture when David was talking about the fact where he said, the Lord has lit my candle. He's talking about the Holy Ghost. The Lord has lit my candle, and I will run through a troop and leap over a wall. Hallelujah. And so it's filled with that supernatural power of God that causes you to walk and live in victory every day of your life. So that's why on the day of Pentecost, you know, Peter stepped forward and said, before he got filled with the Holy Ghost, with the evidence of speaking in tongues, fire baptized, he couldn't even witness to a little girl around a fire. I'm not with him. You know, like some people, they're like, don't you go to Church Unlimited? They want to know first whether or not you're one of us. You know what I mean? You know, but the Bible says they went again unto their own company. You don't have to start talking to somebody that is full of the Holy Ghost very long before you know that they are filled to the overflow. Amen. I'm not talking about American nominal Christianity where you go to church 1.2, you know, 3 times a month. But I'm talking about we live this thing. In him I live, move, and have my being or do exist. Every day in Jesus is sweeter than the day before. Every day with Jesus, I love him more and more. This isn't an up and down, this isn't a religion at all. This is a way of life that Jesus did what he did for us, hallelujah, so that we could live not just in existence. The Bible said in John 10:10, this is the gospel in one verse. Jesus said, the enemy, the thief has come but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. Wherever you see stealing, wherever you see killing and destroying, you know the enemy is there. Brother, it's not God that puts sickness on you to try to teach you a lesson. The Bible, Jesus said, this is why. Jesus, the Bible said, is the exact image of the Father. Jesus wrapped himself in flesh. The Word came amongst us and dwelt to show us the exact express image of our Father. And Philip said, Lord, show us the Father and we'll be satisfied. He said, Philip, how long have I been with you? If you've seen me, you've seen the Father. Oh, and we know that Acts 10:38 says, for Jesus, being full of the power of the Holy Ghost, went around doing good and healing all those that were oppressed by the devil. So Jesus, when he shows up, he always shows up triumphantly, and he always undoes what the devil had meant for evil. God turns it around for good. That's another reason why we shout. What kind of church is this? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Shh. I can feel him even now. I can feel him even now. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Shh. I'm seeing palms on this Palm Sunday. Hallelujah. Lift it up. The Bible said, let men everywhere lift up holy hands without wrath and doubting. God, this is a Palm Sunday church. Hallelujah. Well, praise the Lord. I got to get into this message this morning. Everywhere Jesus comes in is a triumphal entry. You got to get him involved in your situation. We talked about this last week. You know, the Bible said, literally, Paul said, there was a time when you got to stop speaking in the language of men and take it to another level. You got to start speaking in tongues. You got to bring that thing higher. You got to start speaking in the tongue of angels. Devil, you messed around too much. He said, when you speak in tongues, you speak to God and not to men. There comes a time when you got to stop asking your cousin, and you got to stop asking your uncle and your aunt, and you got to go to a higher, but you got to stop talking to men about it and start talking to God about it. Every race of people has their own language. And God says we are a new race. New creatures in Christ Jesus. And we have a native language. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And I told you guys last week, you know, Brother Corey knows this. Some of you that let, you know, like, you know, some of you, if you live in a household where they speak more than one language, that's beautiful. Right now, I'm trying to learn Spanish because one of my goals is one of these days I'm going to get up here and I'm going to preach an entire message in Spanish and somebody else is going to translate into English. And I'm going to tell you, we may not have to, because you know what the Bible said? The Bible said on the day of Pentecost, the Spirit of God fell on them, and each man heard in their own language. Oh, hallelujah! So watch what God's going to do. Thank you, Jesus. There's no limit to what God can do. And there's no, that means then that if there's no limit to what our God can do, then there's no limit to what you can do. Through Christ who strengthens me. All things are possible to them that believe. We got to get God involved. You know, when somebody gets real mad and English isn't their first language or whatever language is in their first language, when they get upset enough, they'll go and start speaking in their native language. Some Christians got to get a little more upset at the things that the devil is trying to do to you and trying to do to your kids and trying to do to your family. Some of you got to get a little more. You know, the Bible said the kingdom of heaven suffers violence and the violent take it by force. Stop being, hallelujah, nice about this thing and start speaking in your native language. Get God involved. You know you're in trouble. Right, Brother Corey? When she starts going off in Spanish, your wife starts going off in Spanish, Brother Corey has Google Translate out. He's like, that's why I love Brother Corey's up there in Spanish. You never heard dirty South Spanish like that. What? He's from Alabama, praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God is a good God. Can you say amen? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Another level. God says, literally, the Lord says, you are seated with Christ in heavenly places far above. Far above. The devil is under your feet. Can you say amen? Hallelujah. It's another reason why we shout. It's another reason why we dance. You know, if you jump a little bit, there's more pressure that comes down on the head of the devil. Although people wonder, oh, I don't think it takes all that. Oh, I don't think you understand what Jesus did for me. The Bible said, he who forgives little, but he who forgives much, he loveth much. And if you, hallelujah, if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, where would I be? I know what he's done for you. You may not know, but I know. And I'm not going to have an opportunity to give him praise and to give him worship and let it just go by because I want to be subdued or sophisticated in the eyes of some man. I want him to know I love him with everything that I got. That's why David knew that. David was a worshiper and a warrior. You can be both. Just because you worship God don't mean you're some milquetoast Christian or somebody can walk all over you. A worshiper always, always is in charge of every situation. That's why David, you know, I don't want to get ahead of myself, but listen, David in the book of Psalms said, let everything that is within me, with all that is within me, bless his holy name. Everything that is on the inside of me. Everything that is on the inside of me. And see, sometimes you have to talk to yourself. Man, I got to get into this message this morning. Sometimes you got to talk to yourself. You know, David, when his soul and his countenance, sometimes you wake up and there's something you may not even know what it's called, but you just don't feel the way that you know that you should feel. And we don't walk by sight. We walk by faith. So I'm not talking about all that. But sometimes, you know, you feel like on the inside, something's just not right. David had a prescription for that. He began to talk to himself. He talked to himself and said, "Soul, what's wrong with you?" You got to speak to yourself. That's why the Bible says, "What now shall we say to these things? If God be for us, why art thou downcast, O my soul?" Sometimes you got to talk to yourself. Get right. Line up. Because what's happening is your soulless nature is trying to take over. That's why I said you got to bring it to another level. The quickest way out of that is through praise. The quickest way to get God involved is to praise Him. Hallelujah. Is this too much? Do I need to slow it down on the... Yeah. I know it's Sunday morning. We're supposed to be a little more reserved on Sunday. We have to get Jesus involved in the situation. And one thing about Jesus, he was not ashamed to get involved. He was not ashamed to get involved. Jesus loved to show up where the enemy was. He loved to get into the middle. The Bible, there's a scripture in the Bible, I think it's in the book of Ephesians, I think it's in the book of John. The Bible says, and Jesus came down and stood in a level place. The reason why he stood in a level place is so that everybody, no matter what level that they saw, that in the human capacity thought that they were, everybody was able to touch and reach Jesus. Hallelujah. That's why this scripture, unless the Lord builds the house. Put that in the King James for me, please. Except the Lord build the house, they labor in vain that build it. That's the scripture. The Lord told me, as long as this is your house, you have to build it. But if it's my house, I said, I'll build it. Well, brother, that takes the pressure off of me. It's not my house, it's His house. Hallelujah. And we don't labor in the spirit realm. That's under the curse. Can you say amen? The Bible said when Adam fell, he said everything he does is by the sweat of his brow. But when Jesus came and sweated great drops of blood in the Garden of Gethsemane, and they put on him, hallelujah, that crown of thorns, he was reversing the curse for you and I, that we aren't supposed to sweat about it. The battle is not yours, it is the... The Bible literally says in the book of Revelation that we are kings and priests. And if you actually study out the priest of the garment, it was illegal for a priest to sweat. In other words, we're not supposed to get moved by everything that the enemy tries to do. All he's trying to do is test to see if you know who your God is and you know who you are. Never let the devil see you sweat. Turn it over to the Lord. Lord, this is your issue. Lord, this is your problem. Hallelujah. You turn it over to Him. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not unto thine own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct thy path. You want to know what to do? Let Him, hallelujah, tell you what to do. You stay in the Holy Ghost. You stay in the flow of the Spirit, for the sons and daughters of God, amen, they walk in the Spirit of God. There's nothing to worry about. There's nothing to worry about. There's nothing to worry about. The Bible says, worry for nothing, but pray about everything. Be anxious for nothing, but in all things with prayer and supplication, make your request known to God, and the peace of God will guard your heart and your mind. Make your request with thanksgiving. In other words, after you ask him, just tell him thank you. The Bible said in Mark 11, 23 and 24, believe that you have received it and you shall have it. That means I receive it here before I receive it here. When you know that you got it, you just say, thank you, Jesus. I know that it's here. I receive it. I receive it right now. Somebody say, I receive it. You got to get Jesus involved in your situation. Anytime you get Jesus involved, it is a triumphal entry. Except the Lord build the house, they labor in vain that build it. Except the Lord keep the city, the watchman watches, but in vain. That means on our best day, what we do without God is worth nothing. It has no eternal value. Whatever we build without him is worth nothing and has no eternal value. I don't want to get ahead of myself. But the disciples were trying to impress Jesus when he had made his triumphal entry. They were walking through Jerusalem, and the disciples were impressed. But you can't impress the one that made. You can't. How is a building going to impress the one that flung the stars and they're still there? That every grain of sand, he knows them by. Hallelujah. How are we going to impress him, the master builder? The master potter. The Bible said the disciples were walking through Jerusalem. Lord, look at this. Look at the temple. Look at all that stuff. Look at all. Jesus said, he said, all of this is about to be turned upside down. And what the world needs to understand right now, what is happening in our world? The Bible said in the last days, everything that can be shaken will be shaken, and only the things of God shall remain. There was a shaking that is going on in this world. The shaking literally is, the Bible said that this world was not created to carry sin. And so right now, what is the earth doing? The Bible said in the last days, there will be earthquakes in diverse places. The Bible said then, what is it doing? I don't like this. I haven't been created for this. But the Bible also says that the earth and the world is waiting on the revelation of the sons of God. And in this room right now, I know our sons and daughters of God. In other words, the world is waiting for you to rise up to be who God has called you to be. And every one of you are going to do it in Jesus' name. He watches over his word to perform it. He knew you before you were in your mother's womb. And he spoke your purpose. Hallelujah. The steps of a good man or woman are ordered by the Lord. And he's walking with you, the Bible said. Jesus said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for my yoke is easy. And my burden is light. Oh, Christianity is so hard. Where's that say? Where's that in the Bible? Come tell me again, struggling Christian. Where is that in the Word of God? The Bible doesn't say the way of the Christian is hard. It said the way of the transgressor is hard. But the way of the righteous shine brighter and brighter until that day comes. We don't live a life of ups and downs, guys. We live a life of ups and ups. We live a life from strength to strength, glory to glory. Hallelujah. Blessing to blessing. You're not living a life of seasons where people, you know, you go to church conferences and they'll preach every conference, it's going to be your season. Next conference, it's going to be your season. Turn around three times and say, yes, it'll be your season. No, brother, how long, when is my season going to show up? Well, the reason why it's not showing up is because we don't have seasons like the rest of the world has seasons. The Bible said in Psalm chapter 1 that we prosper in every season. We produce fruit in every season. That means you don't have a dry season. Well, Pastor, pray for me. Why? Under the circumstances. Why are you under there? I'm going through a dry season. What's coming out of your belly? Jesus said, if you believe in me, as the scriptures have said, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Even if, can God trust you to go into a, you know, in dry places, that's where the devil hangs out. The Bible said that demons eat dust, brother. I'm going to tell you right now, you're in a dry place, but in you is an oasis of life. And if you just believe Jesus and let that river out, then that dry place will become the kingdoms of our God in his Christ. We're supposed to be occupiers. That means we go into areas that the enemy thought he was under control in, and we let loose the power of God. We release the kingdom of God, and what was there has to flee. Get Jesus involved. Jesus said, let's go over to the other side. That legion of demons, you know, that legion, that guy that had a legion of demons on the inside of him, nobody can control him. Jesus came over and put one chancla on that sand. One sandal he put on that sand. And that devil that nobody else can control fell prostrate before the Lord and said, Lord, hallelujah, and fell before, have you come before our time? Brother, there is no arm wrestling match between the devil and Jesus. The battle is already won. The devil was like, just throw us into some pigs, Lord. Go. People like to say crazy things like, you know, there's a principality over Desert Hot Springs. Why? Why? If the church is here. See, they say they like the reason why. Well, let's go sing over Desert Hot Springs. Brother, singing ain't going to do nothing for you. You got to put a holy foot on the ground. You got to get boots on the ground and say, no, the devil, what was yours? You've now been dispossessed. Hallelujah. Go back to hell where you came from. I'm occupying this territory with the presence of a mighty God. I'm not preaching to a weak church today. I'm preaching to a church that knows who they are in Christ. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. No devil in hell can stand before you. Jesus said, behold, I give you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means harm you. The devil can't touch me. The devil can't touch you. The devil can't touch your family. There is a fiery hedge of protection around you. There is a fiery hand of protection upon you. Who does the devil think he is? He wants to know who you, if you know who you are and who lives on the inside of you. We got, let me go back. We got to get him involved. Now I'm going to start preaching. Praise God. Put Acts 19 and verse 20 up, please. See, right now, whether or not you realize it, the Bible said faith comes by and hearing by the... What do you think the faith level is in this room right now? The faith. The Bible says with faith, they subdued kingdoms. Shut the mouths of lions. There's faith in this room. Faith to heal. Faith to set free. Faith to deliver. Hallelujah. Faith to overcome. Hallelujah. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. They that come to God must first believe that he, and he's a of them that diligently... God is a rewarder. Hallelujah. I said God is a rewarder. I'm telling you, God loves to pour out and to give you. The Bible says he took captivity captive, and while he was showing that the devil, I mean, he had the devil like a dead chicken all over the place. Shut your mouth. Come on, shut your mouth. And the Bible said that as he did that, hallelujah, he gave gifts to men. He's a rewarder. Right now, whether you know it or not, the Bible said, God says, is my word not like fire? Does it not go forth like a hammer, breaking down every hard place? There is no unpowerful word of God. There is no word that God has ever uttered that is without power. Every word of God is full of power and has within it the ability to turn around any situation and circumstance. Sometimes the reason why God's word has to come out like fire and a hammer is because there's calcium or walls built up around people's hearts. And his word will come in such a way that that hammer just keeps hitting at where the enemy is trying to keep. But Ezekiel 36:26, the Lord said, I'll take that heart of stone and I'll turn it into a heart of flesh. And I will place within that heart my spirit and I will enable you to do what is pleasing to me. This is not by might nor by power, but by my spirit. It's not what you can do. It's what he can do through you and what he will do through you. If you'll yield unto him and get him involved in your circumstance and in your situation. Can you say amen? Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. So look at, see, it's one of my favorite scriptures. In one translation, it says, and so mightily went forth the word and prevailed. God's word never fails. Amen. Never fails. Put Isaiah 55:11, and I'm going to get to my message sometime, I think. Is this okay this morning? Yes. Isaiah 55:11. So shall my word be that goes forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing which I've sent it forth to do. No word that is being sent out right now is not going to prosper. Every word is like a seed that is hitting different types of hearts, and it shall produce 30, 60, and 100 fold in every life in this place, in the name of Jesus Christ. His word is a powerful word. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Say, ha ha, devil. He hates that. He hates that. He hates that. That's why the Bible gives us a command in the book of Job. At famine and destruction, you shall laugh. The Bible said that he who sits in heaven laughs at the plans of the enemy. And you're seated in heavenly places. Ha ha, devil. Even if it looks like it's going the wrong way, I know that God is working. Hey. I know that God is working all things together for my good because I love him and I'm called for his purpose. It doesn't matter what it looks like. It matters what he says. Brother, you asked Peter about it on that ship. Looked like it was going down. Lord, if that's you, allow me to do what you're doing. Come on, Peter. It doesn't matter what it looks like, but one word of the Lord will sustain you to walk in the storm of your life. You can walk by the word of God. You can walk. You can walk by the word of God over every storm of life. His word is a lamp unto my feet, and a light unto my path. The steps of a good man and woman are ordered by the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Some people, you know, and I want to share something with you, and I'm not trying to condemn anybody. Some people never saw anybody with the joy of the Lord. It's called holy laughter. And that's what happened. You know, you can go into a church where a lot of people cry all the time. But I just have a question for everybody that cries. See, I grew up in old Pentecost where there were more Kleenex boxes than there were people. And it's sad to me because it doesn't say in his presence is fullness of sadness. But where Jesus is always full of joy. Some of you would be healed in your body if you would just laugh about it. Laughing unplugs wells. Raising up some Isaacs, some sons of the promise in this last hour that is unplugging the wells of their father. Hallelujah. Isaac's name was Laughter. Laughter unplugs some things. The reason why Isaac was named Laughter is because his mother laughed. When she laughed, that thing that she wanted, that she could not seem to get it to come into fruition. Amen. It came into the natural. When Sarah laughed, what she couldn't do before, what her heart of hearts was saying, if I could just have a son, if I could just have a son. As soon as she said, ha ha, devil, that son of the promise was birthed. The way to get Jesus involved is to praise him. When you laugh, Jesus loves to show up in happy places. Nobody likes to go to a party where everybody's sad. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Sharabasa kabor and diabaseke sheisi. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Lift your hands higher as you do, it'll even increase. In the name of. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to his name forever. Some people, you know, you got to, again, bring Sister Dora out. Bring it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Sister Josie, just step out too. You're going to get some of this. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, both of you. Right there, in the name that is above every name, the name of Jesus Christ, you shall laugh more in your latter days than you did all in your former days, in the name of Jesus Christ. That's it. That's it. Your greater days are in front of you and not behind you, in Jesus' name. The latter house shall be greater than the former house. The latter rain shall be greater than the former rain. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Move with the purpose. Hallelujah. Come up here, Sister Marcia. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lift your hands in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Be filled. Be filled with joy, unspeakable and full of glory. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Bring up, Brother George. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 A new song, the Lord says, a new song. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. filled, Lord. Filled to the overflow. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Luke chapter 19 and verse 36. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Everything about this service, God has been speaking directly to you. Everything about this service, He's letting you know. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. These are not drunk as you suppose, but this is that was prophesied by the prophet Joel. Then in the last days I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Your sons and daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. Hallelujah. Your young men shall see visions. Get ready. God is moving by His Spirit. Wasn't quiet on the day of Pentecost. It was just like this. It was just like this. The same Spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells in you. It'll quicken your mortal body. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Go ahead and stand with me. We're about to switch the order of service anyway. Praise the Lord. I'm going to read this scripture and then we're going to let God move. Hallelujah. He's moving now, so just stay in the presence of God. Just keep worshiping Him. Stay in the attitude of praise. Hallelujah. See, hallelujah. Look at this. It says, and as he went, they spread their clothes in the way. I want you to understand, when you get Jesus involved, it's no longer you. You got to remember everything that you were. See, what they were. See, a lot of times, even when blind Bartimaeus, when he heard that Jesus was passing by, it's always a triumphal entry. I don't care what your situation is. I don't care what your circumstance is. When you know Jesus is passing by, hallelujah, it is a triumphal entry. I don't care if you were blind. You were blind, but you're going to see because of the healer that is passing by this way. He said, who is this? Who's passing by? And you know what? He said, it's Jesus. The Bible said blind Bartimaeus threw his garment. In other words, when Jesus showed up, you're no longer what you were. You lay that down. It's a garment exchange. It's the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. It's the oil of joy for mourning. Jesus wants to make an exchange with you this morning. I don't care how you came in this place. Jesus is in this place. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Right there. No. Right here. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 There's about to be an exchange. You're no longer what you were, by the power of the name of Jesus, set free. And when Jesus was come nigh, even now at the descent of the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to rejoice and praise God with a loud voice for all the mighty works that they had seen. What's all this shouting about? What's all this shouting about this morning? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I know you're on duty, but it's all right. Lift your hands. Jesus is passing by. Jesus is touching you. Let the joy of the Lord, that's your strength. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's the Holy Ghost. Be filled now. Filled. Hallelujah. Filled to overflow. In the name of Jesus. Jesus is passing by this way. Hallelujah. Jesus. 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 What's everybody shouting about? Hallelujah. The Bible said everybody that was surrounding him. Let me just say this. You know, in the book of John, or the book of Matthew, it says it like this. And Jesus was the center of the procession. When Jesus is in the middle, that means there were praisers that were surrounding him. When you make Jesus the center of your life, everybody that was there saw what Jesus had done. Bring Brother Michael and Sister Emily. Hallelujah. The multitude of disciples began to rejoice and praise God with a loud voice for all the mighty works that they have seen. That's it right there. Joy. Hallelujah. Laughter. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for the wonderful works. Thank you, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Mighty works. Mighty works. Mighty works. Mighty works. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Look, guys, it said the disciples surrounded him and they rejoiced. For the things that they have seen. What's all the shouting about? See, because maybe the reason why people can't shout is because they've only heard about what Jesus has done and they haven't seen what he could do for themselves. But you can't see the wondrous works of God and all that he has done for you and not shout with the voice of triumph. Brother Corey, who I think was in that crowd? I think blind Bartimaeus was there. I think blind Bartimaeus was in that crowd shouting, Hosanna! Hosanna! Hosanna in the highest! Do you know what he did for me? I was once blind, but now I can see. I think Lazarus was there surrounding Jesus, and he said, you know what? I was once dead, but now I was touched by the resurrection and the life, and though I was dead, yet am I alive. I think the woman with the issue of blood was there. And she was given a testimony of what Jesus had done for her. Oh, I went to every doctor. And they tried their best, but their best wasn't good enough. I spent all my money, and now all my money's gone. But I heard there was a healer, and his name was Jesus. And I said, if I could just touch the hem of his garment, I know I shall be made whole. And she said, I pressed through and I touched him and he healed me. But I also know there's some people that are here right now that have seen him. We have testimonies in this congregation today that said, I was sick in my body. But Jesus, Jehovah Rapha, his name is healer. His name is power. His name is life. There's people in this room right now that are shouting that knew if it had not been for Jesus that saved their life. Oh, where would I be today? If it wasn't for the blood of Jesus, if it wasn't for his touch on my life, if he didn't move in me like he did. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. Let the fire of the, come on, fire. That's it. We need this generation. Hallelujah. Shira boranda rabasa kabose kerededididiyabasi. Yanda rabose kerababababasa kabose kerandiyabasaya. Praise the Lord. I don't know how this is translating on video, but it really don't matter. You should have been here. Hallelujah. You should have got here. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I'm going to ask everybody, if you're able to, lift your hands all over this place. Just begin to magnify the Lord with me. Just begin. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just begin to adore him. Just recognize, hallelujah, that Jesus is in this place. Wherever you get him involved. Wherever you get him involved, it's always a triumphal entry. Wherever you get him involved, it's always a triumphal entry. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, don't wait. Don't wait for a man to touch you. Reach out, reach out, reach out. Let Jesus touch you as he passes by. Don't settle today. Don't settle today. The violent take it by force. Today will be your day. Jesus is going to touch you today. Jesus is going to change you today. You'll never be the same again. Santo. Sharabora baba samose kerandarana namasa kamose iriamase. Fuego de Dios. Iramora baba sakamose. Rio de Dios. Thank you, Lord. Gozo. Gozo. Mighty Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Touch your Lord. Touch this little one, Lord. Thank you that the fruit of her womb is blessed. Hallelujah.
My last blood test in Eisenhower was normal.
Her last blood test in Eisenhower was normal. That's our healer. In the name of Jesus, we give you praise. In the name of Jesus, we thank you. Sorry that you're God, our healer. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. You're off duty? Filled to the overflow. Let the joy of the Lord touch your daughter. Thank you, Lord. Everywhere we invite you into is triumph. Thank you for the victory, God. Thank you for the victory. 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 thank you for that. Thank you for that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus. 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 Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Hallelujah. 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 Oh. Oh, thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, mighty God. Hallelujah. Everywhere that we invite him, we triumph. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I know you're on duty, but it's all right. Filled to overflow. Shira basa bose kera basa bose randa da da basa kabas. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Jesus, God, touch my brother today. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Wherever we invite you into is a place of triumph. Wherever we invite you into is a place of triumph. Thank you, Lord, for your mighty touch in his life. God, never the same. Never the same. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you for my brother, Lord. Hallelujah. You're a rewarder. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. That's called a joyful noise. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. 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 Yeah, I was praying for her this morning. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for your healing touch right now that is flowing to Sister Dale. We curse every illegal thing that is in her body even now. We thank you, Lord, with the, just like you touched, God, the hand of Peter's mother-in-law, and she got up and began to serve, the same Jesus is touching her even now. God, our healer, stretch out your healing hand, and we thank you for touching Sister Dale right now. In the name of Jesus, be healed in your body. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. God,
our healer. God, our healer. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Lift your hands. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your joy. Thank you for your peace. Hallelujah. Thank you for our righteousness, Lord. We love you, Lord. Thank you. Bubbly, 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 bubbly. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Touch my brother, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for the joy of the Lord. That is our strength. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, gozo. Hallelujah, bless him, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Joy, 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 joy. I will move up higher. I will move up higher. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, say that one more time.
I just want to thank God. I have no more ringing in my ears. No longer am I going to do my prayer.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. That's our healer. That's right. That's right. Not just, that's done. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Mighty Jesus. What's all the shouting about? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. You know what she said? She said, it's been like, it seems like I've been underwater for all this time. And my ears have been ringing all this time. And the Lord has completely healed me. Hallelujah. Oh, I think you could do better than that. What you celebrate for other people, God will do for you. Hey! What's all this shouting about? Jesus, our healer. Jesus, our deliverer. Jesus, our way maker. Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Woo. Thank you, Lord. Turn that down some. It's funny, wherever you invite Jesus into becomes a place of triumph. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Woo! We might need some designated drivers this morning. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Well, I'm glad I came to church this morning, aren't you? Thank you, Jesus. Glory to your name forever, God. Praise the Lord. A couple weeks ago, the Lord healed Sister D right during worship, wasn't it? Was it during worship? Yeah, during worship. The Lord healed Sister D. Still healed. Yeah, that's what happens. Hallelujah. He heals for keeps. Woo. Thank you, Jesus. The same faith that took you to get saved is the same faith that'll heal you. That's why Jesus told that one man that was laying on the mat, he said, "Your sins be forgiven you." And they said, "Oh," they were all acting, you know, crazy because, you know, Jesus said, "Your sins are forgiven." And he says, "But to show you that the Son of Man has the power to forgive sins," he said, "What's easier, to say your sins are forgiven you or pick up your bed and walk?" And so he said, "Now pick up your bed and walk." And the man got up, rolled up his bed and walked. Amen. See, it's the same anointing. Amen. The same anointing that saves is the same anointing that heals. Amen. It's only us that really make the differentiation. And I know I'm in the Holy Ghost because I can't even say that word right. Hallelujah. Woo. Praise the Lord. That sounded like I was smart. They marveled and knew that they had been with Jesus. These unlearned men. Hallelujah. God is so good. Man, you know, and we expect to hear more testimonies of God healing people and miracles and signs and wonders. Remember, we said in the very beginning that the Lord will confirm his word with signs following. Hallelujah. I'm thankful for his word confirming power. Hallelujah. Wherever Jesus gets involved is a place of triumph. Amen. Hallelujah. That's why we let him in every area of our life. Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Please stand with me if you're able to stand. If you can't, you're that's okay. Praise the Lord. The room is spinning. That's all right. I was up here praising God, and I was like, woo. I was like, whoa. Man, sometimes it gets, you know, man. Hallelujah. I love Jesus. Hallelujah. God is so good. Praise the Lord. I'm going to ask you to lift your hands all over this place. Father, we thank you. Hallelujah. For your for your presence. Where two or more are gathered, there you are in the midst. Thank you, Jesus, that you're in our midst, that you're the center of our lives. Just like on the day of Pentecost in the book of Matthew, you said you were in the center of the procession. And Lord, in this service, you were in the center of this procession. And we give you praise and glory. It's all to you. It's all to you, for only you and you alone are worthy of all the praise and the glory and the honor. You are God all by yourself, and besides you, there is no other God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your word, God, that never fails. Thank you, Lord, for the blessing of the Lord that makes rich and adds no sorrow to it. And Lord, we thank you for your joy unspeakable and full of glory. God, that has filled the life of every believer, every person that is in this place and watching by broadcast even now or at a later time. And Lord, as we leave this place, we don't leave your presence. Spirit of the living God, go before us, make every crooked path straight. We thank you, Lord, that God, you're guiding our every action and our every reaction. Lord, we thank you that you're with us. You're our rear guard. You're our exceeding great reward. And we thank you, Lord, that goodness and mercy are following and overtaking us all the days of our life. We're surrounded by you. And we praise and give you glory and honor. Thank you for an amazing week this week. Thank you that our tomorrow is already blessed. Thank you, Lord, that we get up. Tonight we're gonna sleep refreshed. Hallelujah. We're going to sleep well, dream amazing, and you're going to, as we sleep, you sing over us, you dance over us, and tomorrow we'll get up and drink coffee just because it's good, praise God, not because we have to, because we're tired. We give you praise for everything that you've done in this place, in Jesus' name, and God's people said, amen. Hug on some people on the way out. God bless you. To next Sunday. Invite as many people as you can. We're going to talk about by the power of his resurrection. Hallelujah. God bless you.